Okay guys, you join me today at a place called Badensham. It's on the River Wye again. It's part of the Hereford Angling Club's stretches of the River Wye. I've never fished this stretch before. Bit of a bind to get to it, to be honest with you. I was unsure of how to get to it. First of all, I went through like a wooded area, and I was lucky enough that the bailiff had sort of come down that way, and he advised me, because I had one of those four-wheel trolleys with me as well. He said you'd never get through there. So he said, come back up, and he said he would show me where to go. That's the route I've come on now. It still took me a long time to come down here. So you had to go through a couple of fields beforehand, and then you sort of hit the wooded area again, but it's sort of cut out all the paths where you can't possibly access a river. So I'm on the river now. Fast swim, so I'll swing you round so you can see where I'm actually fishing. So here we are guys, here's the swims. They're very shallow swims by the look of it. I imagine they like could carry an extra couple of foot of water here, and they may be even better again. But that would sort of impair how we could get down to the river really, because there's very steep banks on the side here. And I had a bit of a job to get down myself. So here is my rod. It's a Cadence 12 foot feeder rod. And got myself a little tripod. So guys, on the first cast, unbelievably, I've got a chub. Not a massive chub by any means, but still, chub's a chub. There's a fish. Looks a little chub about a pound. So I'm off the mark already in a new area of the river that I haven't fished before, so I'm quite pleased with that. But let's see how it goes, see if there's any anything else out there. Could be just a one-off, you never know. Guys, before I cast out this time, I'll show you what I've got on the line. Believe it or not, I've got a method feeder. I've buried a halibut, I think it's an 8mm pellet into it. And this mix is a very stiff mix I've made up. There's sort of all crushed pellets in there. There's a couple of halibut pellets in there. Some hen, some robin reds. It's a right concoction. And what I've done is I've just soaked it up for a few hours, and it went like quite soft, all the pellets did. So that's just what it comes out like after a few hours of being soaked up in water. And literally that's all it is, water on it. Okay guys, just had my second chub, slightly better than the first one. Again, sort of about a pound or so. So these fish have definitely put on weight than what they have in previous years, because there you go, not a bad fish at all. So I'll just put that back in though. So hopefully if I can get this angle right, you might be able to see me putting it back in. So I'll stop you. Right. I see it in focus. There's the chub. Just about to go back in. There you go guys. He's on his way. And I gotta show you, there was nothing wrong with that fish whatsoever. He bombed off. So I'll stop you and turn you around again, because obviously you can't see me at them. So that fish, just over a pound again, give it a good bite as well. It was surprising, you know, for a fish of that size to give such a good bite. So what I can tell you again about this Cadence gear, I've got a couple of float rods with Cadence now, and this is a feeder rod, but it doesn't sort of make much difference what size fish it is. The bite will register on the rod, I can assure you that. You know, these are sort of pound, 3/4 pound shad, and even the smaller fish will, you see it bouncing about, but you know, until it's actually taken and you can see it's taken, I wouldn't actually be pulling it in all the time. But I may well change over my feeder in a minute, but at the moment this method feeder, believe it or not, is working. It's like it's got a flat bottom, as you know, all you carp anglers out there. It's a flat bottom feeder, and whether that's the ideal thing for the river, I wouldn't have said so, but it's catch me fish at the moment. But the only thing is, it, you know, because it is a flatbed open feeder, the bait that's on there, sort of the ground bait and the mixture I've got of pellets and hemp and halibut pellets, robin red pellets that have been softened up, it's washing out quite quickly. So that would be the only advantage. You put in a different type of feeder on, would it would hold the bait in for a little bit longer. So I may do that after, but at the moment I'm still catching. I've got quite a bit of bait still with me, so, and the way I'm doing it now is putting quite a bit of feed in the water, so hopefully that's going to encourage more fish to come along. So I'll knock you off again, guys, and I'll be back out. Hey guys, so I'm in again. I've got my third chub, similar size to the other two fish, just trying to keep it from bouncing because it's ready to go, this fish is. So quick show, literally it's going to be a quick show. He's going back in, there you go, it's back in the water. So a lot of you guys are always wondering about exactly where I am. I'm actually in the water, so it's an easy release for me. I just literally got to put it down at my feet because I'm sort of about 15 foot into the river itself. So the swim I've got, it's no more than about 2 foot deep. But what I'm thinking is this, if it's holding chub, it could possibly hold a barbel as well. So we'll have to see anyway. Anyway, so I'll knock you off again. And at this time, by the way, just before I knock you off again, I'm on a proper swim feeder this time, and I've got about 2 foot tail, I suppose, off the swim feeder. So guys, this is the fourth chub. He looks as if he's a little bit bigger. Believe me, they're full of life here on there, I don't know why. It's a nice little fish as well, actually. So there's the chub, and he's going straight back in now. So like I said, the water's at my feet, so he's gone. And there's like probably about 6 or 7 inches of water underneath me, so more than enough for it to go back the way it wants to, with no issue at all. So I did have a little go at float fishing here, but it's far too shallow. It's I wouldn't imagine it's about maybe just over a foot deep, so 12 inches. So what, the only option I've got is with a feeder. So that's what I'm doing at the moment. It's a block end feeder I've got on, big chunky one. There you go, guys. And I'm using one of those bay nets again. And at the moment I'm fishing with garlic luncheon meat. So there's the stuff. And that's by dynamite. So in fact, like I said, the bay net, and I just put it on with one of those feeding noodles. So I'll knock you off again. I think what I may do now is actually position this round so I can get it a bit straighter than what it is now. So there we are, guys, and what I'll do is I'll knock it off for a sec. Okay, so there we go, I've got the end of the rod now. And they haven't cast out yet, so I'll wrap it out then. It's going to be a little bit to get it out. There you go, so I'll show you the end of the rod. The bites, they really are quite aggressive. As you can now, it's sort of, they've all been chubbed up about a pound. So I think I've had four of them up to now so far. They are getting slightly bigger. They're all around about the pound and a quarter size. So the bites are not very regular. So at the moment, I'm unable to show you a bite. It'll be just my luck now, just as I turn the camera away. There'll be a fish on tape. But there's so few and far between. Like I said, I know this swim is no more than a foot deep. I don't think it is the right area. But it's my first time down here, so and I've had to come down a steep bank to get to whaling fishing here now. And so my trolley sort of halfway down that bank, and I've been reluctant because it's so covered right across here to go any distance away from where my actual gear is. I think the best bet for you to do down here, if I was going to advise anyone, is to take like a roaming approach, just like take one of these tripods like I've done. Take a feeder rod and then a rucksack, that's basically it, and just have your bait in a rucksack, and then you can plonk yourself in. You can go in the water if you want to and then go as far down as you want to. You haven't got to worry about your gear. But it's all new for me. I didn't know what to expect down here today. Didn't realise the banks were going to be quite so steep as they are. I can see on the opposite bank, which is an area I fished before on the tennis court section. This section opposite me here is further down from, if you know where the area is, on Victoria Bridge, which is just below the tennis courts. And I can see from looking, there's a couple of spots where you can get in a lot better than what you can this side, because this side is very awkward to get down the banks. Once you're down the bank, like I said, if you were sort of having a roaming approach, you'd be laughing because you've got no end of swims down here, and this is the side if you know you can access so many more swims from over here than you can on the other side. But you have to get down that steep bank. Anyway, enough of me waffling on. Also, I'm going to get back to the fishing for a sec. Any more news and I'll be back. So guys, like the last time I fished down here, so I fished further upstream than this. There are quite a few ducks. God knows where they come from. They seem to have flown from wherever they were. And as soon as they see me here, they sort of like came to investigate. They obviously they're looking for food. They seem to come from miles around and then they just spot somebody and they're at you there. But no, thank God they haven't been played by a swan, because they can be real nuisances, they can, because they won't leave you alone. That's the only trouble when you're actually down in the water, is you can get played by a lot of birds. The moment I can see 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 ducks around this area at the moment. Right guys, it may well be the kiss of death shortly. The clouds are starting to break now. and see blue skies up in there, and with the sun on the water, we all know what that means. The fish just scatter. So I don't know how much longer I'll be able to put up with this, because bites have slowed up as well as it happens. And a little bit of information for you as well, guys. I'm no longer able to put videos out from the Morgan Anglers waters. I've been contacted by the bailiff, and apparently they had a committee meeting about me actually putting the videos out. So by the look of it, that'll be the end of it for me on the Morgan Anglers, waters. Although I never mentioned where I was fishing, obviously people who looked at it knew where the places were, and they decided that they wouldn't like me to put any more videos on. So that's what I intend doing now. I will abide by what the club rules are, and that's it. You just gotta take it on the chin, guys. Hey guys, you can see I'm there. Got my glasses on and my hat now, because the sun's right out, but I've just had a take after some time. Yet again, it feels like it should, but I'll take anything. Because, you know, it's a new area for me, so this will be, if I get it in, my fifth fish. There you go, guys, number five. As you can see, they're all a similar size, so they are definitely an acceptable size to catch, because when I used to catch these fish a couple of years ago, literally 2 years ago, they were sort of 6 ounce fish. They're all like pound fish now, so you'll take that any day. I will anyway. So I'll knock you off again. I'm going to be like this for a while, because the sun is blazing down here, and I'm trying to protect myself a bit. So guys, here comes the swans, looking for an easy meal. If I can give you any advice, guys, is don't feed them. There's plenty of natural food in the water, and if you do feed them, they won't leave you alone. At all. Yeah, I'm getting much closer than I. And what these guys are doing now is just mopping up the stuff that have dropped out of my feeder. Here, guys, a bird of prey, which he leaves probably a buzzard. The old seagulls are having a go at it, and there's another one there. Hopefully, Big Dan up there still flying around, the one is anyway. They're getting badgered by seagulls. There's a few birds up there, I think there's probably house martins running up in the sky. They're going to get those flying ants. So hopefully I pick that up then. I've no idea what come out on here then. Hey guys, just to satisfy my curiosity, I've moved further down into a very fast swim. It's sort of fast right across the river here. It looks as if it's sort of about 2.5-3 foot deep. So I'm gonna have a hell of a job if I do it a babble here, but you've got to give it a go, because like I said to you earlier on, this is the first time I fished at Bathamsham. I seen this peg not long after I'd set up on the previous peg, so what I'll do is I'll sort of turn you round now and pan you round just so you can see just how far I've had to move. So my gear is up on the side there. Don't know whether you can make that out. I might expand it a bit to make it a bit easier for you to see. So my bag and then the rest of my gear is up there, where you can see sort of a blue seat and a blue ground bait bowl. So it's sort of, I'd say about 200 yards I've moved down. You can only give it a go, guys, so, you know, I've had about 4 or 5, can't even remember how many I caught, chub down there, up to about 1.25 pound. But the last chub I caught was sort of about a 7 or 8 ounce fish, and I don't really want to be catching them if I can help it, because you can catch scores of them if you want to. So I'll knock you off again, and if I am successful, I will put you back on. So, guys, Bathamsham. What do I think? I don't really know the area well enough to make any firm conclusion of if it's good or not. There's definitely chub here. I've had, 5 or 6 maybe. I did try one other swim, which I'd fancied sort of about after half an hour after I came down here. It was a fast swim. Over a good long length as well, sort of about maybe at least 100 yards of fast water, and maybe 2-2.5 foot deep, so well plenty deep enough to hold any fish. But I tried to try the feeding in there, but it was bumping about so much. I did have a 50 gram open end feeder on it. It was stopping on again, but I couldn't tell you whether I was getting any bites or what, and if they were bites, they were either small chub or dace, because, you know, all you guys are fish with barbel, you know, if the barbel takes, your rod will just go wrong. It doesn't matter whether it's fast water, slow water or whatever, if it's a tidy barbel, and I'm talking about 8-10 ounce fish or a pound fish even, if it's like a 5 or 6 pound barbel, it will pull your rod round. There's no doubt about that. So it's boiling up now, weather is a turn for the better at last. I've just come back off my holidays, lovely time down in Tenby with the wife. We went down Manabia, and we had nice cream tea there in the garden centre. We went to where was it to now? The botanical gardens. Well, that's well worth a visit. It's like over, I think it's 600 acres. You wouldn't believe the size of the place. Although you've got the actual greenhouse, the dome greenhouse itself, the grounds are extensive, and there's a nice lake down there. Couldn't tell you whether there's any fish in it, but as far as I know, you're not allowed to fish that anyway. That's all part of the same complex. There's little buggies which, if you tell the assistants, they'll take you up to, because they have got a bird of prey centered at the top of the botanical gardens, and you can watch sort of owls and buzzards and kites and all sorts of birds of prey. They have got golden eagle there and a sea eagle and a long-eared owl. So we did go up and I did have a look at that. That was okay, but they're all confined, and if you sort of arrange a visit, you can go out and they'll fly the birds around. It's not for me, that's not. I like to see animals out in the wild. As far as I'm concerned, the cages were far too confined for the animals. I pity them if they have to stay in them all night. Yes, they're getting fed, and yes, they have got water, but they can really stretch their wings apart from when they're being taken out by the person who flies the birds there. And they come back primarily because they've got food for them. And that seems what to be the case there, but it's not really for me there. Anyway, 10 be yourself, Grace. Went up to St. Catherine's Island there. That's worth a visit. There's like sort of pirates and whatever, all mannequins, all at different parts. Because it is the island itself with the building on top of it, is bigger than what you think. Bit of a steep climb, so if you've got dodgy knees, I wouldn't bother. But if your knees are okay, I'd have a look up there. They are opening to, sorry, I'll say that again. They are hoping to open up the top of St. Catherine's Island to visitors, and there may be plans in the future to put a cafe in there. But at the moment, there's ongoing building work done there, and they just want to sort of sort out all the main building first before they do anything else. So the top area, oh, there's a staircase going up to the top there. For the time being, it's out of bounds until the builders have finished what they want to do there. Obviously, for safety reasons, they wouldn't just allow you to go up there just yet. They're probably going to put some type of rail around the outside and maybe a screen just in case small children are taken up there. Because as it is at the moment, there's sort of a bit of a wall there, but you know, quite easily you could fall off that, so they would need to do something with that. So anyway, back to the fishing. I know I've waffled on a bit there about my holiday, but that's why I haven't put any videos out. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it, albeit on the feeder. I did have a little go on the float as well, but the swim was far too shallow for me. It was sort of like a foot deep in some places and maybe a foot and a half in others. And it seems like the area where I am at the moment, because I'm sort of in like fast rapid area, most of this area, even where it's looked favourable for me to fish, that is quite shallow there as well. So there are deeper stretches, but I didn't find where they were today. That's for another day. But for me, I'll be cutting back my tackle if I fish here again, because I brought far too much stuff down, and you don't really need it. Yeah, if you want to bring a trolley, fair enough. But I would just have a couple of items in the trolley, because what I would say, do the banks are quite steep on this one side anyway. I know the other side where the tennis courts are, you can walk down from there and reach this area here from the opposite bank from where I am now. And there are a few swims to be fished there. But I think the best bet for anyone coming down here would be to come down with a pair of waders, park up at Ain, come down with a pair of waders, as I just mentioned, walk up with a rucksack, your rod, a camera like I've got, and there's a little hook on the camera I've got on the stand itself, and you could hang from that a bucket with your bait in it. So you've got your camera, your rucksack, some bait in the rucksack itself, I probably would be favouring maybe sweet corn, definitely take luncheon meat. And just that I brought a feeder rod today, but no doubt there are areas which are worth float fishing as well. But that's for another day for me. So if you like this video, love me waffling on now, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more of my videos, click the notification bell. And if you do care to subscribe to the channel, just click on the red subscribe button. It's a free channel, don't cost nothing. And you might get some insight into some of the waters that I fish. Others which I'm not allowed to put out. Well, you'll have to find out yourself. I.e. the Morgan Angler waters. So with that said, that's it for me today. And I'll catch you again on the banks sometime in the future. And I can't tell you when yet, so it's sort of in between when I'm doing work, you know. If I have a long weekend, I may come out again. So bye for now, guys. Take care and be careful on the banks. Today is dry. Where I'm fishing today, the banks, if they were wet, you would be sliding down these banks. Where I am, you know. And I mean that because they're sort of, well, I would say that sort of incline. And you can imagine what that's like when it's wet. And the downside to that is, I'm just keeping an eye out because my trolley, my four-wheel trolley, which I've got now, it's map trolley, by the way, map four-wheel trolley, lovely trolley, well happy with it, but it's not ideal for coming down some of the banks that's in Bartonshire. Nah, you'd be far better off using that on the other side, on the tennis court area. So anyway, bye guys, catch you again.